Every single business owner at some point has to ask themselves a really critical question. When do I stop hiring? It sounds so simple, but getting it right is the absolute key to maximizing your profit. Today, we're going to break down the simple but really powerful logic behind that exact decision.
So imagine this. You've taken the leap, you've started a business, and things are going great. You need to expand. But what's the magic number of employees? If you hire too few, you're just leaving money on the table. But if you hire too many, you'll actually watch your profits start to shrink. This, right here, is the classic producer's dilemma. To really get our heads around this, let's walk through a case study. We'll imagine a book publisher, and we're going to say they operate in what economists call a perfectly competitive market. Now, all that really means is that they don't get to set the prices. The market does. They're a price taker, not a price maker, for both the books they sell and the salaries they have to pay.
Okay, let's lay out the basic numbers for our publisher's world. They've just invested 60,000 shekels in a shiny new printing press. Every worker they hire costs them $5,000 in salary, and each and every book they sell goes for a flat 100 shekels. That's it. With just these three numbers, we can figure everything out.
So, with those numbers in mind, what's the big question here? Well, it all comes down to understanding their costs. And it turns out there are two totally different kinds of costs we've got to wrap our heads around.
First up, you've got your fixed costs. Think of these as the set it and forget it expenses. For our publisher, it doesn't matter if they print one book or a million books. That 60,000 shekel printing press costs the same. The cost is, well, fixed.
And then on the flip side, you have variable costs. And just like the name says, these costs, they vary. They move up or down directly with your production. In this case, it's the workers' salaries. You hire one worker, your variable cost is 5,000. You hire a second, it's 10,000. You see how that works? It changes with every hire. And right there, that's the absolute key difference. Fixed costs are totally independent of your day-to-day production. That money is already spent. It's what we call a sunk cost. But variable costs are completely dependent on what you do next. They are the core of these short-term decisions.
And this leads us to a really, really important idea. When you're making a short-term decision, like should I hire one more person today, you actually ignore the fixed costs. I know, it sounds a little weird, right? But think about it. That 60,000 shekels for the press, it's gone. It's a sunk cost. You can't unspend it. So the only thing that matters right now are the costs you can still control.
Okay, so we've got our two buckets, fixed costs and variable costs. Nailing this down is the key to everything. So now, with that foundation in place, we can start crunching the numbers that are really going to give us our answer.
All right, first things first. Before we can even talk about profit, we need to know how much money is actually coming in the door. In business speak, that's your revenue. It's the top line number. And the formula for that, it's super simple. You just take the total output, that's all the books you make, and you multiply it by the price you sell each one for. Boom, that's your revenue. Okay, we've got the money coming in figured out. Now we can get to the heart of the matter for our publisher's big decision, calculating the short run profit.
And here it is, the key formula for this specific problem. Take a close look. What's missing? That's right. The 60,000 shekel printing press is nowhere to be seen. Remember, for these short-run decisions, it's just your revenue minus your variable costs. That's it.
All right, let's put this all into action. We're going to build a table and track exactly what happens to the publisher's profit as they hire one person, then a second, a third, and so on. This is where the magic happens. Okay, let's follow the story here. With one worker, they're making a profit of 10,000 shekels. Not bad. They hire a second worker and profit jumps to 15,000. Great. Let's add a third and whoa, we hit 17,000. That's our highest number yet. But hold on. Look what happens when they hire a fourth worker. They're making more books, sure, but the profit actually drops back down to 15,000. Interesting, right? So, looking at that table, the answer is staring us right in the face. Where is the profit maximized?
Let's zero in on that perfect spot, that exact moment of maximum profit for our publisher. This is the answer we've been looking for.
Three.
The magic number is three workers. It's at this exact point that everything aligns, the costs, the output, the revenue, to create the most possible short-run profit. And that peak profit? A cool 17,000 shekels. You see, hiring just two people means you're leaving money on the table, But hiring four, you've gone too far, and your costs are eating into your gains. Three is that perfect sweet spot. So why does it suddenly drop? What's going on with that fourth worker? Well, it's a classic case of what economists call diminishing returns. Maybe the workers are starting to get in each other's way, or they're all waiting to use the one printing press. The point is, that fourth person only adds enough extra output to bring in 3,000 shekels of new revenue, but their salary is 5,000. You're literally paying 5,000 to make 3,000. That is a bad deal, and that is the exact moment you know you have to stop hiring. So what we've seen in this one little example actually reveals a huge universal rule for any business. Let's just call it the producer's golden rule. And here's the big takeaway. You keep on producing, you keep on hiring, you keep adding resources, as long as the extra money you make is more than the extra money you spend to make it. The second that flips, the moment the additional cost is bigger than the additional revenue, you stop. That's it. That is the simple, powerful logic behind maximizing your profit. But that leaves us with one last nagging question, doesn't it? What about that 60,000 shekel machine? We just ignored it for this whole calculation. But you can't ignore costs like that forever, right? So when does that sunk cost actually matter? Well, that, my friends, is a question about long-run thinking. And it's a story for another day.